How ezetimibe controls cholesterol absorption? Ezetimibe is chemically a beta-lactam drug, but it is not a beta-lactam antibiotic, and it is having the following structure. We can observe in this structure the central ring is the beta-lactam ring. Why it is called as beta-lactam? We can observe that the carbonyl group is present. To this carbonyl group, this is the alpha carbon and this is the beta carbon. So to this beta carbon, a nitrogen is attached in the form of a cyclic amide. So it is called as beta-lactam. Now this beta-lactam is the central ring to which the other rings are attached. To this nitrogen, para-fluorophenyl ring is attached. And at the beta position, para-hydroxyphenyl ring is attached. At alpha position, 3-hydroxypropyl side chain is present, which is further attached with a para-fluorophenyl ring system. In this way, the ezetimibe is having a large structure, but the central one is the beta-lactam ring. This beta-lactam ring is also considered as a heterocyclic ring with 4-membered ring system. Since it is having the nitrogen, so we can call it as EZA. And because it is a 4-membered ring system, we can call with a suffix etine, but it is saturated, so the suffix is etidine plus ketone on the ring, so a suffix with one. So the complete name of this ring is the EZA plus etidine plus one, that is the ezetidine 2-one. Here we have to start the numbering from this nitrogen. So ketone is present at the second position. So the name of this ring is the ezetidine 2-one. So ezetimibe belongs to the chemical class of ezetidine 2-one, which is responsible for the controlling the absorption of the cholesterol. Now let us see how this ezetimibe acts. So suppose this is the small intestine, and from the diet, what is the cholesterol that is going to reach into the intestine is going to be absorbed through the brush border of the intestine. And some of the cholesterol can also be secreted into the intestine through the biliary secretion, where this cholesterol is again absorbed along with the dietary cholesterol. Now on the brush border of the small intestine, a receptor is present, that what we call the NPC1L1. This NPC1L1 is responsible for the absorption of the cholesterol through the brush border of the small intestine. Now both dietary cholesterol as well as this biliary cholesterol can bind through this NPC1L1 receptors, and they can be transported through the brush border of the small intestine. Now once this cholesterol is absorbed, then it is going to be converted into cholesterol esters by the LCAT enzyme. Then this cholesterol ester is then going to be transported within the body as the chylomicrons. Chylomicrons are the first transporters which are going to transport the cholesterol within the body. This cholesterol then can be stored into the liver, as well as it can be also be secreted as the VLDL, and finally it can be distributed within the plasma mainly as the LDL cholesterol. And some of the cholesterol can also be coming out of the tissues as the HDL cholesterol. So for all of these, the absorption of the cholesterol is mediated by NPC1L1 receptors. And now this ezetimibe is going to inhibit these receptors, thereby it inhibits the absorption of the cholesterol from the intestine. And this ezetimibe not only inhibits this cholesterol absorption, it also inhibits the cytosterol absorption, thereby it inhibits the both the absorption of the cholesterol and the cytosterols within the diet. Now let us see the actions of the ezetimibe. Ezetimibe is going to decrease the LDL cholesterol, which is called the bad cholesterol, and LDL cholesterol is mainly responsible for the generation of the atherosclerosis. And it also decreases the total cholesterol, as ezetimibe is not specifically acting on any lipoproteins, and it inhibits the absorption of the cholesterol. It can decrease the cholesterol levels in many of the lipoproteins, because the cholesterol is present in the LDL as well as the small amounts in the VLDL. So the total cholesterol in the body is going to be decreased by ezetimibe. And another important action of this ezetimibe is going to decrease the apolipoprotein B. Apolipoprotein B is one of an important factor which, when associated with the LDL cholesterol, may cause a risk for the atherosclerosis. So whenever apolipoprotein B levels decreases, the risk of atherosclerosis can also be decreased. So ezetimibe can decrease the apolipoprotein B levels, thereby it can decrease the atherosclerosis as well as the heart attacks in the patients. And it decreases the non-HDL cholesterol. So whatever the cholesterol other than this HDL cholesterol is called as non-HDL cholesterol. So ezetimibe can decrease all types of cholesterol other than the HDL. And HDL is a good cholesterol which should be increased, actually should not be decreased. And ezetimibe can also decrease the triglycerides. Triglycerides are carried through the VLDL lipoproteins. So ezetimibe can also decrease the VLDL levels, thereby it can also decrease the triglyceride levels. In this way, ezetimibe can affect the total cholesterol, LDL cholesterol, non-HDL cholesterol, apolipoprotein B as well as the triglycerides. And dose of the ezetimibe and how it is given. So ezetimibe is given as a tablet at a dose of 10 mg daily, and it can be given as a monotherapy as well as it can also be given as in a combination therapy. Particularly ezetimibe is combined along with the statins in order to decrease the LDL cholesterol. What are the side effects? Commonly we can observe side effects like the diarrhea, arthralgia, fatigue, dizziness, and increased levels of the liver enzymes with the use of the ezetimibe. And particularly when it is combined with the statins, some of the side effects of statins may be enhanced by the ezetimibe. Particularly the liver damage caused by statins as well as the rhabdomyolysis caused by the statins may be increased by ezetimibe. So when the patients are given along with the statins, the side effects like liver damage and rhabdomyolysis should be carefully checked, because ezetimibe may have a chance to increase these side effects. Clinical uses. Ezetimibe can be used in the primary hypercholesterolemia where there is increased cholesterol levels. This ezetimibe can be given, particularly when there is an increased levels of the total cholesterol, LDL cholesterol and apolipoprotein B, the ezetimibe can be given. And this ezetimibe is also given in the homozygous familial hypercholesterolemia. This is an inborn disorder where there is a decreased removal of the LDL cholesterol, which leads to the accumulation of the LDL cholesterol. In such case, ezetimibe can decrease the absorption of this cholesterol, thereby reduces the accumulation of LDL cholesterol. And it can also become the homozygous cytosterolemia. In this condition, there is an hyperabsorption of these cytosterols. We have seen that ezetimibe not only inhibits the absorption of cholesterol, it also inhibits the absorption of the cytosterols. So the hyperabsorption of the cytosterols can be prevented by administration of this ezetimibe. Advantages of the ezetimibe. It has no interference with the absorption of the lipophilic drugs. Actually, if we take the bile acid binding resins like the cholesteramine can inhibit the absorption of the lipophilic drugs by formation of a complex, but as ezetimibe does not form any complex, it have the no interference with the absorption of the lipophilic drugs like the digoxin and warfarin. And it is having no interference with the absorption of the vitamin A, D, E, K, the lipophilic vitamins. And it can be combined with the statins. This is one of the advantages. In order to control the LDL cholesterol, the ezetimibe can be combined with the statins. And it can also be combined with the fibrates, particularly like fenofibrate, it can be combined. In this way, ezetimibe inhibits the absorption of the cholesterol and cytosterols very specifically without interfering the absorption of the other lipophilic drugs. And it can be combined with the statins and fibrates in order to produce an efficient control of the LDL cholesterol as well as the triglycerides. It is particularly preferred in combination therapy along with the statins in order to control the LDL cholesterol. And ezetimibe is one of the drugs which having unique mechanism of action. It is going to inhibit the NPC1L1 receptors which are responsible for the absorption of the cholesterol and the cytosterols. And ezetimibe, by inhibiting these receptors, it inhibits the absorption of both dietary as well as the biliary cholesterol. And ezetimibe can be used in the hypercholesterolemia, which is either genetically related or non-genetically related. And it can also be used in the situations where there is an hyperabsorption of the cytosterols. So in such situation, ezetimibe is again proved beneficial. And even the side effects of ezetimibe are mild, resulting in the diarrhea, dizziness, fatigue. But when it is combined with the statins, it may increase the side effects of the statins like the liver damage, elevation of the liver enzymes, and rhabdomyolysis. So if any patient observed with these symptoms, when they are given along with the statins, the combination should be avoided in order to prevent the enhanced side effects of the statins. So that's about the ezetimibe, one of the drugs which is inhibiting the absorption of the cholesterol.